name's Tanner.
And I'm Addie.
This week has been a big one, isn't that right?
Yeah, that's for sure. This week was one of our first spirit weeks of the year, and it was Western themed.
Western? That explains all the awesome cowboys and girls I saw out there.
For sure. Now let's take a quick look at this week's best spirit outfits.
Amazing.
I know, right? And there's even more to see at this week's first assembly.
Yeah, I bet. But more on that later. For now, let's take a look at a special new segment by Andre, Gavin, and Addie herself.
What's up, Bulldogs? Welcome to a new segment called Album and Artist Review, where we review top albums and their artists of the recent months. This week is The Rise and Fall of a Midwest Princess by Chapel Roan, which is currently sitting at number 3 on the Billboard's top 100 albums. Chapel Roan, born Kaylee Rose Amstutz in 1998, grew up in Missouri as the oldest of four, with her parents being a vet and a family medicine doctor. At 15, Chapel Roan started posting covers of songs on her YouTube, as well as making her first original song, Die Young, gaining the attention of several record labels. Graduating at 17, she was signed to Atlantic Records and started making her own music. Her first single, Good Hurt, released in 2017, didn't draw a lot of the expected attention her label was hoping for. Soon after, she put out her first EP, School Nights, with 5 songs on it. The album earned a 55 on Album of the Year, not giving her the big break that she was hoping for. During this time, she toured with Vance Joy on the Lay It On Me tour. Up till then, she was still based out of Missouri, flying to New York and LA when she needed to until 2018 when she fully moved out to LA. Chapel Roan started working with producer Dan Negro. In early 2020, she released Pink Pony Club shortly after. This poppy, vibrant song was a harsh right turn from her EP. That same year, she released Love Me Anyway and California. And finally, in September of 2023, she released her full-length pop album, The Rise and Fall of a Midwest Princess, in the wake of releasing 4 other singles. This album exploded, popping her up to a global pop star. Her single, Good Luck, Babe, that came out in April of this year, has hopped up and is still sitting at number 2 on the Billboard charts.
That was awesome. Why'd it take us so long to come up with album reviews? Who doesn't like music?
I know, I'm so glad we have a segment at school that we can all relate to.
Music is just the best, but you know what's better?
What?
Movies! Let's check out Venezia and Lily's movie review.
What's up, you guys? Welcome to our first movie review of 2024. This week we are reviewing Deadpool and Wolverine. So we've never actually seen any of the other Deadpool movies, but it doesn't really matter because this movie explains both storylines along the way.
And I mean, there's fine and funny men, so why wouldn't I have watched?
It was so worth the 2-hour runtime.
I really like the beginning when they show the cast names on Deadpool's weapons, and this actually goes back to previous movie intros as well. And I also enjoy Hugh Jackman and Ryan Reynolds' duo and how their opposite personalities play well off each other on screen. And also the fight scenes, you know which ones. Plus, who doesn't love the silly dog? I think this film is worth 4.5 stars. You should go see for yourself and decide.
Yeah, Billy, I agree. The movie was chef's kiss, 5 out of 5 stars.
See you next time, Bulldogs.
Gosh, that movie was so good. I watched it twice.
Trust me, I know. I went first opening weekend. It was the best.
Alrighty, Tanner. I think it's time we talk about our futures.
What in the bulldog spirit are you talking about, Addie?
The club fair. Duh. Let's check it out.
Queen Creek High School offers so many different clubs. Some of them include Avid, Band Council, Chess, Choir, Clay Club, Creative Writing, DECA, SCCLA, JROTC, FFA, HOSA, Key Club, Link Crew, Theater Robotics, Media, Stuco, Yearbook, and many, many more. But let's go talk to a member of Key Club right now.
Okay, the primary focus of our club is helping the community and helping the people. For example, we did the church drive, clothing drive, and we You just have to get a permission slip and have your parents sign it, you sign it, and just pay $20.
Now, just one last thing before we close out, and that was this week's first assembly. Let's check out all the fun we had.
Well, Bulldogs, that's all we have for you guys this week. Make sure you come to our first home football game on the 30th and buy your tickets for HOCO. See you later, Bulldogs!